Okay? The following example is like this. And this is the example. In this example, it says that a child pulls a wagon along level ground by exerting a force of 15 pounds on a handle. So the child is holding this part. Okay, and move this wagon. And move this wagon. Okay? Yeah. So it's pulling this wagon. The handle is like this. And the degree, that makes an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal. Okay, because the handle looks like that, so it will make with an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal direction, as shown like this. Okay? As shown like this in the figure. Okay, handle, horizontal, ground, 30 degrees, it is given. It may not be like that, but here, you know, for the calculation purpose, we assume that's 30 degrees. Find the work done in pulling the wagon 120 feet and round the answer to the nearest two decimals. You see, how the work is defined in physics is the force times the distance. The force times the distance is 120. 120, that will be the distance. That's the work. The amount of work is done is defined by the force in the same direction. Not in this direction. The force in the same direction. Okay, so here, let's say, so then we want to find out really this force was what? Was like 150 degrees, but we want to find out this, how much is actually on this direction. So we have to decompose this F. Okay, but we know then that will give us a projection we just did before. Because, you know, we assume, what? We assume the light goes up, from up, top, down. So exactly here, you'll see the projection of the force on the horizontal direction. Okay? So down here is that the length of the force, or the magnitude of the force is 15 pounds. And that's what we were given here, okay, 15 pounds. All right. And then we then have a, we want to do the composition, looks like. Because this will give us the force projected in a horizontal way. Then we know the force in this way, in a horizontal direction, we have a how much force. And then how far we go, then we can have the amount of work. We know down here, the projection, we said F on AB, this vector, this direction, makes B work a lot, as I said before, is because this AB appears twice. F appears only once. What is AB? AB is what? Starting from the starting position and ending at 120 feet away. So starting position is here and ending is here. So in physics, this 120 is no longer as a number. It's reviewed as a vector. Okay? So 120 in this case is only the magnitude of this vector from A, starting point, to the ending point, B. Okay, that's the meaning for AB, meaning for AB. So in physics, we don't review this as a number. We review the object moved from point A to point B, the direction in horizontal way, and the magnitude is 120. So in this way, two elements in vectors, they all have. So we say this is a vector. Okay? And then the force, apparently it has directions and it has magnitude. Magnitude is another vector. So force F has a projection on AB. Okay, we know the magnitude for AB is 120. We also know the direction is on the left-hand side. Okay, that's AB. And we know upstairs is vector F dot vector AB. Okay, that's the formula for the projection from the top to the light comes from the top, and the shadow of this vector F is this direction. We'll call this law, which is the decomposition of the force on the horizontal direction. Okay, now both sides, you know, actually in this case, we don't really need to use this formula. We don't really need it. It's because of what? We already know this, the degrees, okay? We know degrees is that if here is 150, the magnitude, and here is 30 degrees, then we know this, how long this path would be, okay? Yeah, we know that. That would be 15 times cosine theta, okay? Yeah, again, if you want to see the details, that would be what? The adjacent side over hypotenuse F is cosine 30 degrees. Okay, adjacent side is also the projections. Okay, so both sides times the magnitude of F. You then can cancel that. Okay, cancel that. So you then have the projection or adjacent side is 15. This is 15. Is 15 pounds. Okay, 15 pounds. And then times cosine theta. So you already know how long the projection is. Yeah, how long this decomposition of this force in the horizontal direction. Yeah. So the actual force in horizontal direction is 15 pounds times cosine theta times the distance. Distance is 120 feet. That is the amount of work. Okay. So we can find out 120 times 15 by using our calculator right here. That's 120 times 15 times cosine 30 degrees. You then have a 155885. That's the number right here. And then the unit is actually feet, pound. Okay, because you have a pound here, you have feet here, so it's feet, pound. And that's the amount of work. Okay. Sometimes, in this case, we are done. We are done. But you know, I want to talk about more, a little bit more, is that if you times the length of B, this vector, in this case, is 120, you may cancel this one with this one. You may cancel this one with this one. So F dot AB, equals what? Equals the length, equals F dot AB, because those two are canceled. And here left-hand side is the length of AB, which is 120, times what? Times the composition. The projection times the projection, okay? So it's the length times the projection on the horizontal way, in the horizontal way. So this is the amount of work. So dot product, the meaning in physics is the amount of work. Okay? Remember that. Dot product of a force and another vector, AB in this case, is actually the amount of work. So dot product in physics is the amount of work. Okay? Sometimes if you are given the decomposition, those are the details you got to figure out. Okay? Yeah, actually we are dumb. Alright? And then the dot product is actually the amount of work. If you are given two vectors, in our case is that F in horizontal direction is 15 cosine 30 degrees left hand side, if you think this is the origin. Okay? Origin. And then horizontal vertical decomposition would be 15 sine 30 degrees. And AB is negative direction if here were origin and you have a 120 I. And then you see F dot AB is 120 negative dot negative 15 cosine 30 degrees. Okay, that's the details down here. Negative, negative. All right, so you have a positive. So negative 15 cosine 30 degrees times negative 120. And here 0 times this number, it crashes. So eventually we have the same answer with that. If we are given, if the vectors are already decomposed, okay, so this way would be easier then. Right now here we can directly figure out, so that's why I said we are done. Okay, so this is the application for the dot product in physics means what? Means the amount of work. And that's also the application for the projection. Yeah, this is the formula for the projection, and we actually used how do you calculate the cosine theta in vector theory. Okay, so actually this is a very comprehensive application. Okay, I'll see you next time.